Hello, my PPC family and friends. Pastor Brian here with a quick bite, living the word. So the thought I had for this morning comes from a lot of sources, but ultimately, you know, I think sometimes what happens in these times of struggle, difficulty, suffering, however you want to look at it, sometimes we have a tendency to feel like we're alone in this. It's like if you're choosing to do this, you're alone in it. If you're choosing to do that, you're alone in it. If you're choosing to, you know, whatever the case may be, I mean, whatever course your walk is in, sometimes you just kind of feel alone in it. And so I was thinking about that this morning, and I was thinking about, first I was reminded of the prophet Elijah. You remember when he went up in the mountain to the cave and basically lamented to the Lord that, hey, there's none left, Lord, but me that serve you, you know, and I'm the only one. And the Lord's like, no, I've still got men. Don't worry about it. And kind of to prove his point to Elijah, he's like, he says, here's the deal, Elijah, and he sends the whirlwind, and he sends all these things like this. He's like, and I wasn't none of those things. I'm paraphrasing here, guys, right? He goes, but he was that still small voice, you know, and I think sometimes we have to recognize that still small voice of the Lord. But what I really want to talk about, though, is when we feel like we're alone, I'm always reminded of a story. And the story comes from 2 Kings chapter 6 when Elisha, and his servant, you'll remember basically the king of Israel was going to go pass by a certain way, but the king of Syria had laid in wait basically to destroy them. And so Elisha had sent to the king and said, don't go this way because they're to kill you. Again, I'm paraphrasing here, guys. But ultimately what ends up happening here is so the king doesn't go that way. And then the king of Syria says, well, tell me how they keep knowing this. And he's like, well, honestly, it's their prophet keeps telling them what you're thinking of when you're in your bedchamber. In other words, God keeps revealing to his prophet what it is that you think you're thinking about in private. And so the king of Syria says, okay, fine. And he sends down a multitude, an army, in other words, to go get Elisha. And they get down there, and it comes in verse 15. I just want to read to us real quickly here. I think we get one of those amazing verses that we hear quoted all the time, even sometimes by the world, but I think that we need to really recognize. So we're going to pick it up this morning in 2 Kings chapter 6 and pick it up at verse 15. Actually, look it up at verse 14. Therefore sent he thither horses and chariots and a great host, and they came by night and compassed the city about. And when the servant of the man of God was risen early and gone forth, behold, the host compassed the city both with horses and chariots. And his servant said unto him, alas, my master, how shall we do? And he answered, what a beautiful answer. Elisha answers, and he says in verse 16, and he answered, fear not, for they that be with us are more than they that be with them. And Elisha prayed and said, Lord, I pray thee, open his eyes that he may see. And the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw, and behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire round about Elisha. Now, I love this story. And why I love this story is because here he is. He's like, fear not, for there's more for us than that are against us. And I think sometimes in our life, brothers and sisters, we need to recognize that even though we may feel like we're alone and it feels like everything's coming against us, that there's actually more for us than are against us. In particular, if we're walking in the way that the Lord would have us to go, if we're walking with the Lord, we're staying faithful to Jesus Christ, he's on our side. And we know his multitude of angels. So in other words, there are definitely more for us than that are against us in this time. And so I love that thought. Just open their eyes and let them see that there's more for us than there are against us. And when he opens the eyes of this young man, he sees the chariots of fire on the hills around them, surrounding them. But you know what I find amazing about that story? Is they don't have to fight. Those chariots of fire don't have to come down and destroy that army. What does God do? He just confounds them and blinds them in essence, basically. So that what? That Elisha and his servant just walked right through the host of them. Didn't even have to walk by them. And so, in other words, they went forth in confidence, knowing that God was with them, even if they were walking alone in a big multitude that was against them, because they knew ultimately they were not alone. There was more for them than that was against them. So keep that in mind today. Whatever you come against, remember, as he says there, fear not, for they that be with us are more than they that be with them. I love you. We love you. God loves you. And God's got you.